Am I actually remembering it, or am I constructing it?
Am I actually remembering it, or am I constructing it?
And I can see the windows.
When I first saw Pamela, what I was really struck by was this kind of holistic way in which she approached technology, electronics. And it was similar to the way she approached her voice. In fact, they bleed into each other in really interesting ways, and you can't have one without the other.
I teach a digital instrument design class where we learn to create digital musical instruments. So basically, we're working with sensors and microcontrollers. And Pamela has been doing exactly that.
I know you're not in love.
When she came in and did her demonstration, we talked about her sensors that she used. We talked a lot about her gestures, her approach to mapping.
The instruments that I was using just now were that instrument, which is my voice. And then I was using several different gesture control instruments to manipulate the sound, sometimes just to play sampled sounds.
Our students are very well educated around the implications of systems and how to implement things, and to be able to get into a discussion around the artistic implications of those kinds of decisions with an artist who's living it all the time, that's invaluable. You can't get that kind of experience really anywhere else.
These instruments, just like any other instruments, have a gesture vocabulary that you learn, and it comes from playing the instrument and how to get out of it what you need. When you're thinking about instrument design, does this instrument give the user of the instrument room to be expressive with the instrument?
We're involved in technology here every day. But really, like, what is it for? And when you're talking about something like music or the arts, I think it really is about helping people express themselves to make human experiences that are interesting. The focus always needs to be on how does this connect to people?
These tools, machines, instruments, whatever we're calling them, I like to see those as something that we express ourselves through them rather than trying to train them so that they can take over the expression. Here I feel like this whole idea of art and technology is much more integrated and seen as a continuum and not as these like separate things.
I always feel like sometimes with like electronic music that it can be so hard to like really feel like the audience is always included in what's happening. Like Pamela and I share conceptual ideas about having that grounding in like, our voices being the center of the material. I think there's that connection between how we feel about our voices and how we feel about ourselves. It is the only instrument that really has that sort of embodied nature living inside us. And I think technology for me is kind of situated in like really like emphasizing that sense of embodied control.
I immediately started thinking, what about larger and on a stand? And so you're standing up and now it's, you're standing there, you're with your audience. And when you're manipulating it, it's right in front of you and they see you, you know, manipulating it as opposed to it's a small thing on your table it's down and you're here and you're at the computer and you're, you know, it's almost like the difference between gesturing at someone or pointing at someone versus putting your hand on their face and stroking their cheek. The assignment that I gave to Evan's class was that they all go out and record a found sound. Sounds that were not necessarily intended by the original maker of that sound to be used in art.
And I was just like,
and take that sound and make a very short composition out of it.
It really expanded what my definition of music was. Before, I thought it was just instruments and vocal parts and things like that. But now, like, as I go about my daily life, sometimes I'll hear a sound and I'll just, like, record it.
Wow, there was this great moment where the voices got really dense. Suddenly we maybe were let into some place or something. It was a nice moment.
And you'll see a big muscle here, right?
Person.
Now look at that big muscle. And just
when somebody who's out there in the world doing the things that you admire comes and spends time with you and pays attention to you and tells you, oh yeah, what you're doing is interesting too, and what you're doing relates to what I'm doing. Those are the moments you remember as a student.
Did you pack your own bags? Did any unknown person ask you to carry something?